Hey guys, welcome to my YouTube channel. This is Pinky Science Academy, Form 4, Paper 1, Revision Questions and Answers. Please like, subscribe, and comment. The diagram below shows the heating curve of a pure substance. Study it and answer the questions that follow. What are the physical states of substances at point W and Y? Point W and point Y. So at this point W, the substance is a solid. At point Y, the substance is a liquid because this is solid. Then solid melting, change of state from solid to liquid, and then liquid gains heat. It changes from liquid to gas at point Y. At point this point, it turns to gas. So at Y, it's a liquid. Explain why the temperature remains constant between point B and C. The temperature remains constant at point B and C. So here at point B and C, the heat supplied is used to break down the forces of attraction holding the solid particles together, and therefore the temperature remains constant at that point and as the solid turns into a liquid. So you are told to consider the reaction below, that is chromate 7 to decomposes to give chromium ions and hydrogen ions. So you are supposed to use oxidation number to explain whether the above reaction is reduction reaction or not. So you start with the oxidation number of chromium in this, in chromium 7 is 2 minus. So 2Cr plus 7 minus 2 minus 2. 2Cr, this one is equals to negative 2. Here is equal to negative 2. Then 2Cr plus 7 times minus 2 equal to negative 2. So 2Cr into bracket 7 minus 2, it's negative 14, equals to minus 2. So 2Cr is equals to you just take this to the other side, it becomes positive 14 minus 2, it gives positive 12. So Cr is equals to 12. Cr, so it's 2Cr is equals to plus 12. 2Cr is equals to, so you'll divide by 2 both sides, 12 divided by 2, you get 6. So the oxidation number of chromium ion in this chromium is negative 2. So you start with Cr plus 4 times minus 2 is equals to negative 2. Cr is equals to minus 8 plus into bracket minus 8, which is equals to negative 2. So Cr is equals to 8 minus 8 minus 2, therefore it gives you 16. The next question, you are told that during dry sulfur 4 oxide was passed through two pieces of colored silk, both in a gas diagram. So here you have dry sulfur 4 oxide gas and I passed through dry piece of colored silk cloth, and then you have dry sulfur 4 oxide through a wet piece of silk cloth. So you're supposed to state the observation in the gas jar. So in the gas jar 1, there is no observable change because you've used a dry piece of cloth, silk cloth. In experiment 2, the silk cloth was bleached, meaning it turned color. Write equations to explain your observation in flask 2. In flask 2, we've seen the bleaching of the silk cloth because it is wet. So sulfur 4 oxide plus water to give that, and then this sulfurous acid plus dye to give sulfuric acid plus dye minus oxygen. So that is what results into a colorless substance. The equation shows some reactions. Use the equation to answer the following question. You have ethanol, step 1, to turn to ethene. So that is dehydration. You dehydrate or you remove the water in that alcohol to give an alkene. Step 2, alkene, you are breaking the bond to become alkane. So that is hydrogenation. You can use platinum catalyst. Explain why ethane burns with a more smoky flame than ethane. So ethane burns with a more smoky flame because it has higher percentage of carbon compared to ethene. So ethane burns with a more compared to ethene. And then you are told the third member of the alkene is converted to its corresponding saturated hydrocarbon by hydrogenation using the bond energy value given below. Answer the questions that follow. So you've been given the bond energy and then you are given the value. So this is determine the enthalpy change of conversion of the third member of the alkene to its corresponding saturated hydrocarbon by hydrogenation. So the third member of the alkene is this one. So you break it the bond using the hydrogen or platinum catalyst to get you are now the butane. Graphite is a non-metal most commonly used on an electrode. State 2 properties that make it to be used as an electrode. It is a good conductor of electricity and it is also unreactive or inert. Graphite is an allotrope. Distinguish between allotropes and isotopes. So allotropes are different forms of an element in the same physical state, where isotopes are atoms of the same element with the same atomic number but different mass number. Here you are given a diagram. You are told to use the information in the circle to answer the questions that follow. So what is the name given to the energy changes in H1? This and then H2. So H1 is lattice energy, H2 is hydration energy. The next question, you are told the first, second and third ionization energies in kilojoules per mole of element GnR are given below. Define the term first ionization energy. So it's the minimum energy required to remove the first electron from the outermost energy level of an atom in its gaseous state. So apart from the decrease in energy level, explain the difference between the first and the second ionization energy. So of course the first ionization energy is less as compared to the second ionization energy, because once the electron is removed from the outermost energy level, the remaining electrons are strongly attracted to the nucleus, making it very difficult to remove an electron, the second electron, from the outermost energy level. calculate the amount of energy for the process. So you've been given R to changing into R plus 3 electrons. So enthalpy change, you've been told the R for R, it's 420 from the table. That is 420. The first energy, ionization energy, then plus 3100 in the second ionization energy, plus 4800 in the third ionization energy, giving you 8320 kilojoules per mole. When solid zinc carbonate was added to a solution of hydrogen chloride in methyl benzene, there was no observable change. On addition of some water to the mixture, there was effervescence, explained. So hydrogen chloride in the methyl benzene is molecular, so no reaction will take place. But with the zinc carbonate, but when water is added, hydrogen chloride ionizes to form hydrogen ions, which react with the zinc carbonate, producing carbon 4 oxide. The diagram below represents incomplete setup of a apparatus that can be used to prepare carbon 4 oxide gas. Complete the diagram to answer the question. You are told to write the equation for the reaction taking place. So you have calcium carbonate plus hydrochloric acid to give you calcium chloride, plus water and carbon 4 oxide. Name liquid Z, that is conch sulfuric acid. It's used as a drying agent. You can also use calcium oxide. State two advantages of using dry ice over ordinary ice as a refrigerant. Dry ice lasts longer than ordinary ice, and then leaves no residue behind, and it is sublimes with ordinary ice, which melt. So then you're given a flowchart there. Those are the steps. The next question you are asked, name the cations present in X. The cations present are copper and zinc. Anions present are the sulfate ions. Write the equation to show how the white precipitate in step 3 dissolves. You have zinc hydroxide plus ammonia to give you zincate plus hydroxide ions. Name the process. It's called neutralization reaction. A student intending to prepare lead sulfate reacted lead metal with dilute sulfuric acid. However, he was not successful. Explain why he was not successful. Because insoluble lead sulfate is formed, it coats the lead metal, preventing further reaction with the acid. Suggest the method the student could have used to prepare lead sulfate. He should have prepared the sulfate using a soluble lead salt with an insoluble sulfate. So where the lead ions react with sulfate ions to form lead sulfate as the solid. In an experiment, ammonium chloride was heated in a test tube. A moist red litmus paper placed at the mouth of the test tube first changed blue, then red. Explain. Ammonium chloride decomposes on heating to form ammonia gas and hydrogen chloride. Ammonia diffuses and the hydrogen chloride turns the red litmus paper blue. And then it later turns blue litmus red. Element X has two naturally occurring isotopes, that is X22 and X20. Its relative mass is 21.8. Calculate the percentage abundance of the more stable isotope. So the most stable isotope is the most abundant element. So that's why you use let Y be the abundance of the most abundant isotope. So you can equate using this equation, 22Y plus 100 minus X multiplied by 20, which is the mass number of X, is equals to 21.8. of 100. So you're going to get 90%. Fractional distillation of crude oil is used to prepare the following fractions of petrol, diesel, petroleum gases, kerosene, naphtha, bitumen. Below is a simplified diagram of the fractionating column used. So on the diagram, write the names of the fractions in the correct position. So then you're asked which fraction is used as a jet fuel. It's kerosene. What process is used to convert higher fractions to lower fractions? That is cracking. Carbon 4 oxide and silicon 4 oxide are both covalent oxide, but carbon is a gas where silicon 4 oxide is a solid with high melting point. Explain. So carbon 4 oxide has simple molecular structure with weak van der Waal forces of attraction, while silicon 4 oxide has giant atomic structure with a strong covalent bond that requires a lot of energy to break. The ability of hard water to conduct electricity falls when the water is boiled, but it is not much affected when the water hardness is removed by addition of washing soda. Explain. So when you boil, it precipitates the magnesium carbonate and thus reduces the concentration of ions. When you add sodium carbonates, exchange of ions responsible for electrical conductivity takes place. When sulfur is heated in a boiling tube, in absence of air, yellow crystals melt into golden yellow, mobile liquid at 113 degrees Celsius. The liquid changes at 180 degrees into a dark brown, viscous liquid. More heating is to above 400 degrees, produces brown, less viscous liquid. Explain why molten liquid becomes viscous. The rings open to chains which join up to form long chains which entangle up. If the brown liquid at 400 is cooled rapidly by pouring it into cold water, which form of sulfur is produced? Plastic sulfur. State the observation made when sulfur is heated in a deflagrating spoon. It melts and burns with a blue flame. The table gives some information about some certain chemical substances. The letters used are not the actual symbols of the element. You have the electrical conductivity, the melting point, and the boiling point. Two substances cannot be element. Which are these? It has melting point of 712, boiling point of 1418. Poor conductor of electricity, good conductor when it's in liquid, and good conductors in. So that is C and E. C and E, they cannot be elements. A substance that is likely to have giant atomic structure, F. A substance that is likely to consist molecules which produce ions when added to water, it's B. Study the diagram and answer the questions that follow. Write the equation for combustion of propane. Propane is C3H6, so it will decompose or burn to form CO2 plus H2O. CO2. The pH of substance K was found to be less than 7. Explain. Carbon 4 oxide is less acidic. It dissolves in the condensed water to form a carbonic acid, which has a pH of less than 7. Carbonic acid is a weak acid. Explain how you'd separate a mixture of nitrogen and oxygen gases, given their boiling point is negative 196 and negative 183. So you cool the moisture to temperature below negative 190 degrees Celsius to form a liquid. Then you start boiling. A nitrogen distills off at negative 196 degrees Celsius. Dry carbon 4 oxide gas reacts with heated lead 2 oxide as shown. Name the process undergone by lead 2 oxide. That's reduction. No, reduction is removal of oxygen from a substance. We can also argue that lead ions gained electrons to become lead metal, which gain of electron is said to be reduction. Name another gas that can be used to perform the same function as carbon 4 oxide in the above reaction. Hydrogen gas. The setup below is used to correct gas F provided by reaction between water and calcium metal. So that gas must be hydrogen. They're told to name the gas. The gas is hydrogen gas. Then you're told at the end of the experiment, the solution was found to be a weak base. Explain. Calcium hydroxide is slightly soluble in water and only few ions are produced. Give one laboratory use of the solution in the beaker. It is used for testing for the presence of carbon 4 oxide. It also used in preparation of ammonia. In terms of structure and bonding, explain why graphite is used as a lubricant. Graphite structure has layer that are joined by weak van der Waal forces that slide over each other. Thank you guys for watching. Please subscribe, like, and comment.